It's a book about the history of artificial intelligence and a little bit about the future of artificial intelligence as well. And it follows six characters in six different time periods, all of whom were involved in creating an artificially intelligent doll. So it starts with a character named Mary Bradford, who is a pilgrim in the 17th century writing diary entries. And then it goes to Alan Turing, who is the man who first conceptualized the idea of a computer and first predicted that computers would exist. And then it follows a character named Carl Detman, whose work is based on that of Joseph Weizenbaum, who created the first chatbot, basically the first conversational computer program. And then it moves into the future with a character who invents this program for artificial intelligence. And finally ends up with a little girl who has one of these artificially intelligent dolls. I mean, I've always been interested in artificial intelligence. For a long time, I thought I wanted to be a doctor and particularly a psychiatrist. So I spent a lot of time in mental hospitals and studying the mind and the idea of sort of an artificial way of creating a perfect human mind, the ideal human mind, the ideal companion has always been an interesting idea to me. And then also just reading about the history of artificial intelligence, I was so moved by the actual characters who were involved in creating artificial intelligence. Often they were people who were told at some point that their intelligence or their humanity was somehow less or different than actual or real humanity. And, you know, for instance, the first women who programmed the first computers who their jobs were later taken by men who were coming back from the war, or the refugees from Nazi Germany who were all integral to creating artificial intelligence, and Alan Turing, who was prosecuted for homosexuality. All of them at some point had kind of struggled with the feeling that they somehow weren't normal or complete humans. And I found it moving that they made it their life's work to create and protect and advocate for another kind of intelligence that would also be frightening for some people in the world.